नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, वन एंड ऑल, लेट मी टेक द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ न्यू एजुकेशनल पॉलिसीज एंड इट्स इम्पॉर्टेंस व्हेन इट कम्स टू the growth factor of the students by and large. Specifically, when we talk about pandemic attack, today the digitization aspect has really evolved. So there is ample of opportunity for the digital marketers or the companies that are looking at creating that platform for the students. What one needs to understand at this point in time is it's too early for anyone to come to a conclusion that this is what is a solution for everything, because not everyone would be able to have that digitization aspect, because out of 100, if we really see, maybe 10 or 20 have laptops. Still there are backward areas where they do not have enough of infrastructure when it comes to the digital way of presenting things. The point over here is, if government is looking at the digital marketing aspect, it will definitely take some time. The point over here is, we need to understand the very basic point of infrastructure availability. Is the government going to procure the same and give to the people? Is one of the questions which one needs to really ask. Sad, but truth has to be told. Not everyone would be able to have that digitization aspect which government is looking at. Coming to the schools, colleges, universities, and other research methodologies, research institutions, they also have the same issue. Forget about pandemic attack, forget about calamities or whatever it is. What if other natural calamities which would create a kind of hindrance to the growth of the education system? Is there someone to address this question? Definitely yes. Digital marketing and digital marketers or digital professionals will definitely have that edge right now. But what if things go wrong with the technicalities? That is also one of the primary questions which one needs to ask for himself or herself. The point is, if this question is addressed, I feel digital marketing is the best place. I am pretty comfortable. Since I have laptop, I am doing it. But again, people think about quality, people talk about various other things. How do we address that part? This is one of the very primary aspects which one needs to understand. Simply thinking about digitization of the education system, digitization from the viewpoint of technological advancement, etc., etc., doesn't make any sense. Is there someone who could really address this? Is what my question is. It still remains as an open-ended question. Not every school, not every college, not every university can afford that. Unlike US, Germany, Australia, etc. They do have infrastructure. Definitely yes. That's fine. Even before competing, can we really look at it? Is what? I have a question on this. It's a big $100 billion question. Think about it. This is a very important aspect when it comes to the new educational policy. And teaching coding language, is that very important right now? I remember when I finished my graduation and other thing, Y2K issue came. After that, another issue came in the software. Softwares are developing dynamically and strategically. So how do you really compensate that? Is the biggest question which one needs to really address. The point is, can we address this? Teaching coding or decoding language at a very early age, producing prodigies, is that a solution to the to whatever that technical advancement is all about? I don't think so. One needs to have proper infrastructure in place. Do we really have? Teaching coding language, let's say that someone is teaching a coding language to the below poverty line student who is intelligent enough. How does he or she apply in his real life when he or she is not having the laptop, or his or her father is not able to afford it? This is one very basic question which one needs to ask. Thus, I conclude this video with a positive note and pointers being, is there someone who is going to address the infrastructural part when it comes to coding and digitization, or the digital marketing? Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. May the Guru's grace be with all. Have a nice day ahead. Shri Gurubhyo Namah.